Okay, so maybe the game servers will be up. We'll wait a little bit. I don't know what will happen with the other game. This as well. Okay, Singapore game. I think that game is dead. That we want. So there will definitely be an argument for review or replaying the game. Team Captain Dave is very responsible to that. And maybe we'll get it later today with the. We'll get it today with the options to see what will happen there. I'm very curious how that game would have ended. Here we have UK TRL, so they're starting in like 5 to 10 minutes, so I'll just run a. So, quick deck overview. We have Tyrell Reigns versus Tyrell Banner of the Dragon. One of the more unconventional choices with double Wildfire Assault and Heads on Spikes. Game of Thrones, a very interesting choice. We see Tyrell, and on the UK side, we have Reigns. An interesting choice with Tyrell, I would say. Not the most convenient one that you would expect to see there, but you get what you get. We have King in the North, which is a normal inclusion for the Tyrell restricted aside from Great Hall. And then we have Crown of Golden Rounds for the additional King trade. We have Tinder March and probably a lot of small and weird awards and lands that we've never seen. We see Aleri, Luton, Maze. Oh, that's the draw Maze, one of the more interesting choices. Paxter, Rendil, Renly, Garwan is a ward, Knight of Flowers is a ward, Varys, of course. I mean, if you're reading Kingdom Magic, of course you would have one Varys for a escape valve. Also, one of the few decks that we see Morghulis in it. Very interesting. I mean, happy to see it somewhere at least. On the scheme side, we have Game of Thrones, Power Behind the Throne, Pulling the String, Varys Riddle, Wildfire Assault. Again, without Exposed Duplicity, something that we saw last year was Exposed Duplicity was in every range of Castamere deck. But now with the ban on Kingdom of Shadows, looks like people are not worried about the Shadow decks to that extent. And then on the Tyrell Lion side, which looks like to be a... Actually, I have no idea what this is. Also, Banner Lion without Red Keep, I completely do not agree with this. At least they are Treachery and Hangerman. So, interesting what the deck is trying to do. Looks like it's again Tinder Margaery deck, but a lot with a complete different number of... A little bit of passive power gain. Well, let's see if we are still waiting for the players to show up. Yep. Again. A Tinder March deck, so a complete mirror match, I would say, in the way that it is playing. We see Confiscation, which is rare to see, but it's not that hard. Here, of course, for all the wards and ladies that the Lannister banner brings, like Small Tommen, we have Flancel, Jaime, Gregor. There will be a lot of Marcella and like Joffrey will be the main engine of the deck for gaining gazillion power. Yeah, a pretty interesting deck. Economy, yeah, restricted Great Hall. Makes sense with this insane curve of a deck. This is a lot, I would say. But makes sense for the curve. And James has a very interesting choice of events with Lay Waste and Nightmares. At least at when we started building, I warned my meta that Lay Waste will be almost everywhere, and no one surprised we can see Lay Waste shown at a few places. And looks like we are in the game. Oops, wrong window. Big one, I mean. Yeah, James is on the right there, that his deck is just a good old Tyrell field with a different agenda. Good stuff. And then we have a little bit a different and more interesting approach to the game. But well, when mean, you can say that your deck is a junk team, but then you have all the renown in the world, so it does not matter how junk it is, it's closing the game in a second. You may not be, and we see already Marjorie marshaled. Here, move a little bit stuff. Of course, just jumping into a game after the interviews is a little bit tricky. Also, a lot of other stuff where I'm doing and aligning my layout and stuff. We see Hedron Spikes versus at the gates. A very nasty. Oh! Hashtag skill, that's what we call this play. This is one of his only three of Wards and Ladies in the deck. There is no close call, but there is March, which makes me very happy. Yeah, sorry, from James perspective. Always good to watch James play with all the banter back and forth. He doesn't let things get him down. I mean, this is one of those pulls where it would completely win you the game turn one, like hitting Karenly, hitting Box Stannis, hitting in a Martellus Ramsay, for example, or other one of those Vaiman. I would be tempted to say Mirror there, but Mirror can be resurrected in so many different ways. I mean, main recycled, so yeah. We see Old Town, so a little bit of passive power gain is on the field. That will help. And draw for James. Guard. And now we have to find a Ward and a Lady for him. To pump a little bit his strength and icon distribution. And of course the scheming seven, where should we go without that staple of Martell card. I'll do a shameless plug considering how many people were there, so twitch.tv shameless plug. For them to join the stream, have a good old commentary. Also, we are without delay this time around, so at least not that much of a delay. So it's the base one that this server has. So time for the Tyrell Wyan to marshal. You see red one straight, road road, so red one straight and a reducer. And unfortunately not enough economy for a big Lannister worker lady. Definitely we're gonna see some type of lady joining the board. Although Lancel will be the one that and milk to the Skipton, to the Septon. So deny that recursion engine of power and cards. After a charter is removed from the challenge, pay one gold to give that charter plus two strength or minus one until the end of the phase. One of the more niche options that they are. The Lion deck, as mentioned, nothing in particular there on the event base, so is there just for the curve, I assume. In fact, that is the case. And she is a lady for the Joffrey shenanigans. And immediately intrigue challenge for James. I don't expect him to do a military here, although the wildfire will be coming and one sail will be removed, although I won't be surprised considering how the economy of James that he's going to valor this board away. And that's why we see him doing a little bit of challenges here. Also, the Knight of the Rich can defend the intrigue challenge, and it's a little bit early to be that worried about the power. And I think this will be it for the challenges, unless James wanna bait him into no, he doesn't want to. So we're going to see probably just a power challenge and then dominance for James, so which will tie them for the first round, aside from Old Town educating guess. What did the character count in GM deck? Like 32. So obviously always name a character. One in dominance and then in standing you will definitely get that card. I missed when the card in shadow went, but I assume that's Pinch of Powder. Because there is no reason to marshal the captain in the, no one playing marshals captain in the shadow. So. And looks like James guessed correctly that it's going to be an Arbor Knight. And this will be it for the first round. 4-3 in power, archery. Here now, James got one extra from the plots. And as mentioned, I won't be surprised to see either. No, I'm pretty sure it's going to be a Valor here. For James, yes, it's a little bit of early Valor, but considering that we will see a Wildfire Assault that will help bring the care. Now this is skip to one turn, but then Lancel. Now Lancel will be sacrificed. The Joffrey joining, so maybe then this meta will go. Because it gives a little bit of strength. And let's see if we'll see a quick duke for Joffrey or not. Warden of the South will give the necessary strength to trigger at least the agenda. Although March is pretty formidable. Arbor Marketplace. All the working ladies. Interesting, there is a 3 gold safe, so what could that be? No shadows. No ambush shenanigans. There are 3 Frey Worldlings in the deck. So I'm more and more liking this Terrell Lion deck. We see Arbor Knight, Sir Colin. Duke and the Reckoning for the Challenge Chase with 5 gold for James. Old Bill Bone, Yes. One. Tarot card in general, the acceptance. And as I said, Page of Fallen. But then there is a water end is right, going strong for challenges, shenanigans. A lot of unfriendly stuff to come. Also interesting enough, I mean, James always been a fan of political disaster. So we with the economy being just red wine straits, arbor and gates of the moon, that makes a lot of sense. And we see a high tower in the deck, one of old time forgotten cards just because Mace was so dominant with that strategy. So we saw a military challenge that was defended by the Knight of the Reach thanks to the Wardens of the South. I imagine how much clicking this is for his character on the platform. And then are we going to see a power challenge? Third corner by himself is 6, so quite a lot of power has to be put into the challenge, and looks like that will not be the case. The question is, do you want to defend it or not? Defend with the more winning stuff, and then this gives you enough strength to go on the offense. Now the question is, who is going to do the inter challenge? Will it be the Scheming Septon and the Arbor Knight, which will be 7, and then 3 triggers on the Arbor Knight or what Renly strike for 6 strength from Renly. Looks like no intrigue challenge, so what's there? Oh, there is pulling the string, so we are definitely going to see intrigue push through here. I don't think that Ghost will have to leave it on a post. And this will force James to spend resources. Okay, going strong, which will add another 4 to the challenge, that will be more than enough. A first copy of Hand's Judgment. And okay, that was it. No, we didn't see, we see Ali discarded. And then the power challenge now is definitely won. And you'll see probably Joffrey staying for the dominance. No superior claims or lay wastes. All town for a character and reduce red wine straits. That card will be drawn in the taxation phase, in the standing phase. So. Get that one passive power and hold down. Yep. And James guessed correctly, so it was vocation this time around, it didn't shift.
Oh, and a power.
Looks like now is the turn for the wildfire. See a snap pick from the end into King in the North. So a good. Is there a king? No king. So it's a solid choice to counter the first trigger of Marjorie. We see guard, knight of the rich, and Sir Colin chosen for the reins, and for Wyan we have Marjorie, Lancel, and Joffrey. This could have been a big swing if Kings of North was not the retreat card, but as mentioned at the beginning, Tyrell makes a lot of sense to have that one as your restricted. You see Crown of Golden Roses marshaled with the red wine traits. Now you can do all your root shenanigans and a bodyguard. And looks like that will be it. You no idea what's in the card in Shadows. At this point, I think this is definitely the pinch. Curious why that so much resources are saved. But then it's also possible for James to be drawing that. We have that scenario as well. Rose Garden. How many of the 7 charters are in the wild deck? Probably not that many aside from Alice. We see Boy King in the Tyrell wild side, but no Crown of Golden Roses, which was interesting. Interesting. I feel like one of the bodyguards could be the Crown of Golden Roses nation. There are no scepters, lady in waiting for companion. Yeah. No target for Alice in the deck. At least I don't see one. I may be missing something. And we see Mace Marshall for 6. So looks like James will not be winning any trick anytime soon. That crucial intrigue challenge. His overall strategy. Oh, sorry about that. But we may see a sneaky power to jump one of the cards. Looks like a power challenge for 5, just to threaten that pinch. And then, unfortunately, Renly is no longer on top of the deck. Not that much of a strength there to be added with the scheme except on top. Was there a possibility for a stronger card to be left on top? No. Oh, yeah. We're seeing a defense for 3. So James needs like 3 more strength to find from somewhere. Unfortunately, the friendly right will not help. We see the old time informer drawing a little bit of cards here. But it feels like the red lion is very in a very stable situation here. And let's see what James will discard. We see Bodyguard and Lord Rendis right discarded. As mentioned earlier, it's sad to see that the Renly got buried into cards. We see military challenge coming from Lancel, to be not defended. Interestingly that we see that Guard was chosen for the claim, considering all the attachments that you would like to have to work on that charter. Both Bodyguard and the Crown, which now there is a chance to be discarded for the entry challenge. But it has to be done with March. So looks like Obi-Wan was in shadows. So this will be 7. And the question is, can James find a little bit more? I know he will be content with just with the solid defense here. And a power challenge from Mace. For a turn where Ghost said he's in a Derek. I think Derek is playing Derek Young. Yeah. For the positions where Derek said that it's a tough position for him, looks like he pretty much went unscathed there. Not much harm was done to him. Also, James is also in a relatively safe position as well, although he is missing all of his big pieces. Here. Now with heir to the Iron Throne missing and no Dukeris, looks like now the reserve will be more secure. If James, yep, when we see reset into Game of Thrones. In Game of Thrones. So this definitely hampers the both, although both decks are with a very established economy, was the Old Town used? In standing, Luminous, nope. So James decided not to use it. And we see him triggering an out for an Arbor Knight, so just to fix a little bit his hand. And set Arbor Knight from 1 up to 2. And this time James Margery joins the board. Pleasure Barge, good old Pleasure Barge from first cycle. Drawing cards like crazy. Currently the minus one gold is paid for the get to the moon, so you see. seems like he drew in all his locations milk for March. So looks like we won't see any type of, although he is running confiscation the Terrell Lion deck, so maybe he may at some point he will be forced to remove that milk if there is no other attachments on the board. James is not turning confiscation in any shape or form. Yeah. Pretty harsh there. I mean, one is dead, one is drugged, so feels like a fair trade there to some extent. You see unopposed intrigue, which will trigger the agenda. James will flip probably into pulling the strings. I would assume pulling the strings to get the opponent's air to free Margery or head on spikes. Mm-hmm. And let's see what it is. I think the hair here is a little bit more constructive, just because we will remove Margery's handicap and we will break another character in the board that could do a challenge. And see Brienne. And that is the second meal gone. There is just one more for James to handle. And we see Lady in Waiting discarded. Power challenge with renown. Military ambush. I don't see any type of ambush in the real deck, unfortunately, aside from the Widow's Wail. So we won't see any surprise challenges coming here. Yeah, the draw was very bad on Derek's side. Looks like he, after the heads on pikes, the deck decided he doesn't deserve any more wall. And now for James. Yep, PD makes sense. And then what the close call for Margery to draw a card. And the additional card draw. So let's see if this will help. And goat is selecting Arbor Marketplace and Red Wine Straits, and of course the pleasure barge is immune, and we have Arbor, Red Wine Straits, and Old Town is safe. And removing that extra gold for Derek. So the bar will actually hit him to an extent. Although 7 gold is pretty a solid amount. Rose Garden. User. So what could bring Paris? Yep, Paris feel like could probably bring him out of the game, but James is pretty close to winning and with the standing Old Town. Although the stealth will help for the power challenge, definitely. Why did Tyrion knelt? And we see Randil with crown, so now Brienne doesn't defend. It looks like that will is more than enough to seal the and the bodyguard. Brienne, considering the reset affairs from the other side, I don't think the bodyguard matters that much. So that one gold could have been something else. Now let's see what tricks they are in Derek's sleeves now. Although, aside from a Widow's Well, I don't see much shenanigans happening out of the ordinary. Yeah, looks like, as we saw earlier, there was a big crash to the game server. Yep. Like the lag is not a problem in James' eyes.